Okay, I want to go through a quick example about the sampling distribution of PHAT. According to a study conducted by a statistical organization, the proportion of Americans who are satisfied with the way things are going in their lives is 0.76. Suppose that a random sample of 105 Americans is obtained, complete parts A through C. So, before we dive into A through C, I want to mention first where they show here that the proportion of Americans who are satisfied with the way things are going in their lives is 0.76. That's P. That's our proportion. So 0.76. And so this is the proportion of Americans. And that's important because we're going to start talking about P hat, which is P with that little hat on there. And P hat, so that's P hat. P hat is us looking at the sample that we take and getting X, which is the number of people that have the characteristic we're after, out of the entire sample size. So first, before we get to p-hat, it says describe the sampling distribution of p-hat. Well, to see if it is approximately normal, we have to see if n times p times 1 minus p is greater than or equal to 10. Well, n is our sample size. It tells us we have 105, so we know that n is 105. So to figure this out, we're going to have 105, so n times p, which is 0.76, times 1 minus 0.76, and that will give us 19.152. That is indeed greater than or equal to 10. So we are good and know that this can be approximated by the normal distribution. So now we're looking at our possible answers. We know that C is wrong because this is saying that the distribution of P hat is uniform, and A is wrong because it's saying it cannot be approximated by the normal distribution. So it's neither of these. And now the difference between answers B and D is the standard deviation of the sampling distribution. So sigma sub p hat. Well, we can calculate that with this equation right here. So the standard deviation of the sampling distribution is going to be the square root of p, which is at 0.76. times 1 minus 0.76 all over n, and n was 105. That's going to give us 0.0417. And it says to round to three decimal places, or our options are rounded to three decimal places. So we're going to pick D as our answer. For part B, it says using the distribution from part A, what is the probability that at least 80 Americans in the sample are satisfied with their lives? So there, we're going to start off by drawing a standard normal curve or a bell curve and pretend that's a nice beautiful bell curve. We know in the middle is going to be our mean, and our mean is going to be 0.76 and it's wanting us to find the probability of at least 80 Americans. Hopefully, you're looking here and notice that 0.76 and 80 are very, very different numbers. Well, the reason is because we have to convert this 80 into a p-hat. So that is saying that we have 80 Americans out of our sample of 105. And so p-hat is just going to be 80 divided by 105, which is going to give us 0.7619. So 0.7619 is just a little bit to the right of 0.76. So just a little bit to the right. And that is 0.7619. And it's saying the probability that at least, so at least means this many or more. All right, so now we're going to use our calculator to do the number crunching for us and find the area under the curve to the right of 0.7619. To do that, we're going to use the Normalcdf. As a reminder, you're going to have the lower bound, the upper bound, the mean, and the standard deviation, all separated by commas. To get there, we're going to do second, vars, go down to number 2. Our lower bound is going to be this 0.7619. For an upper bound, we want to keep going, so I'm just going to enter in a really big number. For me, I typically just list several nines, then another comma. The mean is 0.76, and then our standard deviation is 0.04, it's 1.7, but we're going to use 0.042. And this is giving us 0.48196 and so forth. It wants us to go to 4 decimal places. So the area over here is going to be 0.4820. And hopefully you were expecting it to be very close to 0.5. The mean, 0.76, splits this area in half so that there is 0.5 to the right and 0.5 to the left. And since this number is so close to the mean, we were expecting the area to be close to 0.5. Now, for part C, it's wanting us to do 79 or fewer Americans. So this is a very similar example. So we still have our normal curve. We still have 0.76 as our mean. And now, this is saying 79 or fewer Americans. Again, 0.76 and 79 are completely different kinds of numbers. So we need to figure out that p-hat. So we're going to have 79 out of 105. So 79 divided by 105. Gives us 0.7524. So 0.7524 is going to be just a little bit to the left of 0.76. And this is saying the probability that 79 or fewer is going to mean the area to the left. So we're going to do a similar idea using Normalcdf. So I'm going to go second, vars, down to number two, or I could just hit number two. For lower bound, well, there's not really a lower bound because this technically keeps going forever. So I'm just going to do a really big negative number. The negative is underneath your three and in parentheses. So negative, and again, just several nines with a comma. Our upper bound is going to be that 0.7524. The mean is still 0.76. And our standard deviation is still 0.042. And we're getting 0.4282. So this area is going to be 0.4282. So that would be the probability that 79 or fewer Americans in the sample are satisfied.